Hello, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Smiley, and today I am very, very excited to be talking with you guys, not about the brand new Netflix Punisher series. Unfortunately, I'm just like 4 episodes away from finishing it, so I'll probably be reviewing that next week. But today, I wanted to review one of the older Punisher movies, my favorite of the 3 that I know of. There was one with Dolph Lundgren in the 90s, I think. No idea. One with Thomas Jane and John Travolta that came out in 2004, and one with Ray Stevenson that came out in 2008. Today, we're going to be talking about the Punisher that came out in 2008, and that's called Punisher Warzone. So Punisher Warzone, directed by Alexi Alexander, and stars Ray Stevenson as the Punisher. Now, I haven't seen Ray Stevenson in many other roles. I've seen him in like maybe 1 or 2 other movies as a side character. So when I watched this movie, I didn't really know what to expect from his performance. And Alexi Alexander, she's directed a couple episodes of like Supergirl and Arrow and things like that. She's directed 1 or 2 episodes of each of those, but she doesn't have like a huge directing credit. So I didn't really know what to expect going into this movie. Holy shit. It was very, very entertaining. It's not an Oscar-worthy movie. It's not like Best Picture 2008 worthy, Best Independent Picture of 2008 type shit at all. It's just very, very fun. It's more of the fun side of the Punisher. The guns, the action, the blood, all that good stuff. So that's what you're gonna get with Punisher Warzone. And one of the coolest things about this movie is that a lot of the stuff is practical special effects. Back in 2008, a lot of people were moving away from practical special effects and switching over to even like things like blood squibs would be done in post, which just, it always looks terrible. You can always pick it out when someone adds a blood squib or a muzzle flare in post because it doesn't exactly light up the room as it's supposed to, or the blood just looks very animated, and it's always very distracting in movies, and I always hate when they do that. So this movie thankfully uses a lot of practical effects, even though there is one scene that involves a rocket launcher where the special effects are a little bit silly, but it's okay. It's a silly movie, so it's okay for there to be a scene that's just a little bit silly. Ray Stevenson as the Punisher, I love. He was a major badass, and he really pulled off the role. The only thing I didn't like about him was how he would walk back to his base, like, in public. He would just have, like, the Punisher skull on his vest and have guns and everything on him and just be walking through the streets of New York to get back to his little underground base, and I was just like, you know, someone's gonna fucking follow you. And that's the weirdest thing about the movie. Well, I mean, there are weird scenes, but that's the thing that sticks out as, like, weird, you know? I mean, sure, there's a scene where a crazy guy eats someone's kidneys, but it's not as weird as a guy walking down the street in New York with a bunch of guns and no one double takes at him. Now, this movie had Jigsaw in it, and Jigsaw is one of my favorite Punisher villains. He's a badass, and they didn't exactly do Jigsaw perfectly right in this movie. It's not how I would have liked to see Jigsaw done, but it was cool to see him on screen, and it was cool to see him interacting with the Punisher, but it's nothing like the Netflix series where Frank Castle and Billy Russo will be sitting together and you can just feel the tension spiking up. It's not like that, but again, it is fun. It is a fun movie. You'll put this on and you'll enjoy yourself for 100 minutes. And for a movie that's really not trying to say anything, it's just trying to tell this little story, it's good. It's very well done, and I do very much like this movie. One other thing I want to talk about from this movie, and that is Looney Bin Jim. He might have been better than Jigsaw. He might have been fucking better than Jigsaw, this guy. Holy shit. When Looney Bin Jim was on screen, there was so much more menace than Jigsaw. Even though Jigsaw's face is all fucked up and everything, the guy who played Looney Bin Jim, he looked crazy in the eyes when he was on screen. He did something where he just looked mad, and it was brilliant. So that guy really deserves a pat on the back for that performance. Oh, and another thing I do want to talk about in this movie is their version of Micro, which I do very much like. I do love this Micro, and his mom, who watches cooking shows all day, and that's just, yeah, you need to see this. Now, they try and do something emotional in the end of the movie, which doesn't really land all that well. I didn't feel my emotions spike when I saw that scene in the end of the movie, but again, as a whole, it was not trying to be an emotional movie. One scene, they took a little bit too far. So, I mean, this is just a fun, good action movie. And you should watch it if you got nothing to do for 100 minutes, you're looking to pass the time, and you want something that's gonna be entertaining and not be complete shit, I would highly recommend Punisher Warzone. And I'm gonna go ahead and give it a 7 out of 10. It's a good 7 out of 10. So yeah, guys, if you haven't seen the new Punisher series, check this movie out before you do, so you can compare the movies, Billy the Butte, and eventually Jigsaw to the Netflix's Billy the Butte, and hopefully, eventually, Jigsaw. But yeah, once I finish that series, I'm gonna kick out a review as fast as I can. I'm super excited to finish it, because The Punisher is, like, next to Deadpool, it's Deadpool and The Punisher, and those two are probably my favorite, I don't want to call them superheroes, like anti-heroes? Yeah, anti-heroes. They're my favorite anti-heroes of all time. So yeah, guys, that's it for today. Next week, again, I will be reviewing the Netflix Punisher series, and I'll just say this, so far, it's good. I mean, we'll see how it ends, but so far, I'm feeling very positive about this series. That's all I'll tell you right now. So, thank you guys very much for watching. If you liked this, please leave a like on this video. Leave a dislike if you didn't like it. And as always, I hope you guys have an amazing weekend. Keep it kosher. Peace.